Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about double fertilization. That means the fusion of two male gametes brought by the pollen tube, one with the egg which gives rise to embryo and the another with the secondary nucleus or the central cell forming the primary endosperm cell. After the double fertilization, in case of flowering plants, ovule develops into seeds, whereas ovary develops into fruit. Ovule develops into seed and ovary develops into fruit. The covering of the ovule, called integument, develops into seed coat. The covering of the ovule called integuments develops into seed coat. Whereas the remaining parts of the flower, such as sepals, petals and stamens, usually fall off. Sometimes sepals may persist along with the fruit. Ovary develops into fruit. And the formation of seed. Formation of seed takes place by the ovule after fertilization. Now let us discuss about the advantages of seed formation. Advantages of seed formation. Advantages of seed formation. Seed contains the embryo or the developing embryo. Means it has a dormant embryo. Seed has a dormant embryo. Seeds are small. They are light and tough. Seeds are small, light and tough. Hence, they can be dispersed for long distance. Dispersed for long distance. This is one of the advantage of seed formation. Seeds are small, light and tough. Hence they can be dispersed for long distance. Then the second advantage of seed formation is seeds can remain in dormant stage for many months or for years. Seeds can be in dormant stage, inactive. Dormant stage for months or years. So one can store the seeds for long period of time. Hence seeds can be stored for long period of time. Whenever we need to grow a particular plant, at that time we can use such stored seeds. They can be in dormant stage for few months or for about few years. When we require to grow a particular type of plant, at that time we can use such seeds. So these two are the important advantages of seed formation. Two advantages of seed formation. One is seeds are small, light and tough. hence they can be dispersed for long distance, and seeds can be in dormant state for about months or for few years. Hence one can store the seeds for long period of time. Seed contains, for example, seed means it contains seed coat. This is a cotyledon. If you observe the dicotyledonous seed, this is a dicotyledonous seed, for example, green gram. Dicotyledonous example for dicotyledonous seed is green gram, which contains two cotyledons. This is one cotyledon and this is the another cotyledon, two cotyledons, and this cotyledons contains reserve food. These two are the cotyledons. Cotyledons are the reserve food which helps in the development of the embryo. Cotyledons are helpful for the development of the embryo or for the development of the seedling. If you observe the structure of dicotyledonous seed, you can find out two cotyledons. Then once the favorable condition occurs, or in the presence of favorable condition, this dicotyledonous seed, this dicotyledonous seed absorb the water, then it germinates. Dicotyledonous seed absorb the water and it germinates. The process of formation of seedlings is nothing but germination, and this germination takes place in presence of favorable condition. In favorable condition, seed absorbs water, then it starts to produce. Embryo, and that embryo, say this is the embryo. Embryo contains or develops embryonic axis. After germination, in the embryonic axis, we can find out two structures. This is plumule and this one is radical. Plumule and radical are the two structures which can be observed in embryonic axis. Means this embryo develops like this. This is the plumule and this one is the radical. Plumule is nothing but future shoot system. Radical is the future root system. Plumule is the future shoot system. Means this plumule grows above the soil. Say this is the plumule. Later it grows above the soil level and give rise to future shoot system, whereas the radical grows in the soil, inside the soil, and that give rise to root system. Plumule is the future shoot system, whereas radical is the future root system. This is about the germination of seed. Now let us discuss about the reproduction in human beings. So far we have discussed about reproduction in unicellular organism. then reproduction in lower multicellular organisms. That includes asexual type of reproduction, such as binary fission, multiple fission, budding, fragmentation, spore formation, etc. Then we have discussed about the sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Now let us discuss about reproduction in human beings. Reproduction in humans. Human beings reproduce by sexual method, because in human beings there is a well developed reproductive system. In males as well as in females, well developed reproductive system is present, that is helpful for the sexual type of reproduction. Human beings shows different types of sexes, means sexes are separate. In males, well developed male reproductive system is present, whereas in females, well developed female reproductive system is present. That is called sexual dimorphism. Sexual dimorphism. Usually, in case of human beings, puberty occurs at the age of 10 to 14 years in girls. In girls, puberty occurs at the age of 10 to 14 years, whereas in boys, puberty occurs at the age of 13 to 15 years. After attaining puberty, the formation of gametes takes place in the males as well as in female body. And the sexual hormones are also produced by the primary sex organs. Primary sex organs of males. The primary sex organs of the male is the testes. Primary sex organs. In males, a pair of testes are present, and these testes are the primary sex organs. In females, a pair of ovaries are present. A pair of ovaries are present, and these ovaries are the primary sex organs. Primary sex organ means these are the organs in which the formation of the gametes takes place. In case of males, testes are the primary sex organs in which or the testes produces the male gametes called sperms. In females, ovaries are the primary sex organs which produces the female gamete called egg. In males as well as in females, or in boys and girls, after attaining puberty, the formation and the development of the secondary sexual characteristics can be seen. Some of the similar changes which occurs in girls and boys after attaining puberty. After attaining puberty, some of the similar changes occurs in males and females. Puberty is nothing but it is the puberty. Puberty is the period. It is the period, or it's a stage when primary sex organs means either testes or ovary, primary sex organs become functional and start secreting the hormones for the development of secondary sexual characters. Puberty is the period when primary sex organs become functional and start secreting hormones. Primary sex organs start to secrete the hormones for the development of secondary sexual characters. Puberty. It is a stage or period when primary sex organ becomes functional and starts secreting the hormones for the development of secondary sexual characteristic features. Adolescence. Adolescence is the period between the first sign of puberty and achievement of complete sexual maturity. Achievement of complete sexual maturity. It's called adolescence. So the period when primary sex organ become functional and start secreting the hormones for the development of secondary sexual characters is called puberty. The period between the first sign of puberty and achievement of complete sexual maturity is called adolescence. Adolescence is the stage between childhood and adulthood. Adolescence is the period or the stage present between the childhood and the adulthood. Now let us discuss about the secondary sexual characters. Secondary sexual characters means these are the characters which are developed after attaining puberty. And the development of the secondary sexual characters are influenced by the sex hormones. The development of secondary sexual characters. Development of secondary sexual characters Development of secondary sexual characters are influenced by the sex hormones like testosterone in males, the male sex hormone called testosterone, and estrogen in females. The hormone responsible for the development of secondary sexual characters in males is testosterone, whereas the hormone essential for the development of the secondary sexual character characters in female is the estrogen. And after attaining puberty, some of the similar changes, same type of changes occurs in both boys and girls. The similar changes are similar changes in boys and girls. Similar changes in boys and girls includes the development of thick hairs. It includes development of thick hairs in armpits. Development of thick hairs in armpits. Then around the genitalia, armpits and around the genital area or genital area. That means between the thighs. Between the thighs. Then second one is the development of thin hairs. Development of the thin hairs on legs, arms, face. Development of thin hairs. Thick hairs in armpits and genital area. Development of the thin hairs on arms, legs, etc. and face. Then changes in the voice or the high pitched voice, then skin becomes oily, high pitched voice, etc. are the similar changes which occurs in boys and girls after attaining puberty. Development of thick hairs, thin hairs, then skin becomes oily. These are the similar changes. Then the secondary sexual characters which appears in boys. The secondary sexual characters which appears in boys are the development of the mustache, beard, development of the testes, the primary sex organ. Development of the secondary sexual characters in boys. One is development of mustache, beard. Then development of the sex organs. Development of the sex organs. Then voice begin to crack. Development of sex organs like penis. Whereas the secondary sexual characters which appears in girls after attaining puberty is development of breast, then beginning of menstrual cycle or menstruation. Etc. These are the secondary sexual characters which appears in boys after attaining puberty, and these are the some of the secondary sexual characters which appears in girls after attaining puberty. And the development of the uterus, fallopian tube, uterus as well as breast is essential in case of girls, because the development of the baby takes place inside the uterus. And after the delivery, the secretion of the milk takes place by the breast, which is which helps in the nourishment of the developing baby. So this is about the secondary sexual characters in case of boys and girls after attaining puberty. Thank you.